this is MJ from MinIO. In this video, we'll be learning about how to use the mc alias command to add, list, and remove S3 compatible endpoints from your MinIO client. So the MinIO client alias command has three different options. There's mc alias set, which allows you to configure endpoints to use with the mc client. There's mc alias list to see which aliases you have added and information about those aliases. And there's also mc alias remove, which lets you clean up that list a little bit and remove some of those aliases that you have set previously. The mc alias set command adds or updates an alias to the local mc configuration. The following command that we'll show you here adds an alias for the MinIO deployment, myminio, running at the URL myminio.example.net. And mc uses the specific username and password for authenticating against that deployment. So the command would be mc alias set myminio, which would be the alias name that you would use in the future, and then the path or URL to that deployment and the username and password. The mc alias list command lists all aliases in the local mc configuration, and you'd simply use that by typing mc alias list, and you'd see all of them, MinIO and other S3 compatible storage that you've added in here. And the mc alias remove command removes an existing alias from the local configuration. This is if you want to clean up or that's no longer a cluster that exists and you want to just simply remove that from this system. You can use mc alias remove, and in this case, you would be removing the myminio alias. As always, we recommend that you follow along directly with the MinIO documentation. Here are some links, and we'll include these in the description. And now let's jump into a quick demo. So here we are in the demo, and we will go ahead and add a couple of aliases to this, and then list them, and then remove them. See what version we have installed. You can see here the exact version. This was installed using the instructions provided in other videos. If you're looking for these instructions, videos are linked in the video description on how to install this on your various systems. So let's go ahead and add an alias here. The first alias that we'll add is for the initial cluster that we will alias as MinIO1. And you can see here that it was successfully added to the system. And we'll go ahead and do the same thing for another cluster we have up and running called MinIO2. And you can see that that was added successfully as well. Now, if we do a mc alias list, we'll see that along with some other defaults here, like storage for Google, the local host, we also have our two that we just added, MinIO1 and MinIO2. Note that play.minio is also here, as well as a default placeholder for Amazon S3. Lastly, if these clusters are no longer in use, we can use the mc alias remove command to delete them from our system. And now that we've removed those, we can do an mc alias list and see that those two clusters are no longer listed as one of our aliases. That's pretty much all you need to know about the mc alias command. Thanks for watching. Please make sure you check out the rest of the videos in this series to learn how to use other commands with the MC client. And as always, visit us at https://min.io for more information. Or if you'd like to join the discussion, you can visit us at slack.min.io to become part of the discussion. Thanks for watching.